Digital Filipino Bootcamp. My name is Janet Toral, and our session for tonight is all about social conversation. Unfortunately, we're encountering problems right now with the GoToMeeting platform, so we're going to use Google Hangout. It is my first time to try the Google Hangout platform for this webinar presentation. So for those of you who are here tonight in our webinar session, if you have any questions at any point, I hope you can still use the GoToMeeting platform so that you can post your concerns. So if you are having technical difficulty in seeing the screen, just let me know. I just want to confirm if you can see my screen right now. Kindly press that raise your hand button if you can see my screen right now via the channel that I've given. Can you see my screen? Yeah, I'll just wait for our participants to confirm if they can see my screen. All right. Since this is already a recording in progress, so I guess I'll just proceed with our session, and then let's see how we can progress from there and do our presentation for tonight. Okay? So if you have any questions at any point, just use the webinar platform to share if you're having problems or difficulty with the session. So welcome to the Digital Influencer Bootcamp. My name is Janet Toral. So thank you very much for joining us tonight. This is the last webinar session in our free series in the Digital Influencer Bootcamp. We've done around 24 videos already, and we're now posting this at the digitalfilipino.com/influencer. So if you have any concerns, you can participate in our online class and type it there if there's any concern that you may have. And then if you have questions as well, you can post it there. And then if you just like to watch all the webinar sessions that we've had in the past, all you need to do is just view the site, okay, for whatever concerns that you may have. So for first-time participants in our webinar session, basically, if you join digitalfilipino.com/influencer, you will be able to take part by just signing up. So if you sign up as a student, that will give you access to our Digital Influencer Bootcamp for free. And then if you want to join our exclusive e-learning programs, all you need to do is to sign up as a Protégé member, and that will allow you to join our exclusive webinars. All right? And one of the things that we will do with our exclusive webinars where our Protégé members will have access. The first session is all about digital marketing and e-commerce for the tourism industry. And that is basically the same as to what we've done in the Digital Influencer Bootcamp series, but this time it is really more focused for people in the tourism establishment, so that if they have concerns or they would like to learn how to go about, applying digital marketing and e-commerce technologies insofar as the tourism industry is concerned, well, this webinar is basically for them. And then, of course, we're also doing this program to promote the digital influencers, to promote the idea of building up a digital influencers community from different parts of the country. And this all started when we had our Digital Influencers Marketing Summit last year. That's where we realized that there are still a lot of people who would like to learn more about digital marketing, but I guess there's not much a structured approach that will allow them to really learn through it step by step, at least hearing it from a perspective. So in our Influencer Bootcamp, we're giving that perspective, which in this case represents my perspective. However, I hope that for those who participate in our free boot camps, it will give them enough basic information so that they can use it as a stepping stone and learn more from others, because there's so many knowledge resources out there, And I would always encourage a person to get as many perspectives as they can, because the combination of perspectives and being able to process them, try them, and apply them to projects will allow a person to make a better decision as to what digital marketing strategies can work or can apply to them. No? Kumbaga, wala naman talagang nagdo-dominate ng ideas. Wala naman talaga makakapagsabi na siya, alam na alam niya, o pinakamagaling siya. At the end of the day, bawat isa na nagbibigay ng knowledge, halos ano lang siya, limited lang siya dun sa experience niya. So, it is important for students to get as many perspective as they can para makita niya kung ano yung the best na magagamit niya para sa kanyang work. No? We're also doing this webinar series to help prepare also our students. We currently have a certified blog and social media entrepreneur program. And then we noticed that a lot of our participants through the years, well, one way or the other, they were struggling. No? Not everyone, of course, but some end up struggling in doing their projects, among others. And part of the reason why they're struggling as well is the fact that there's so much to learn, there's so much to process in so far as doing live projects is concerned. Like if you're going to launch a blog, there's so many things that you need to do, from building it up, writing content, building a community, and promote your content. And that takes a lot of work. And if you proceed in marketing, there's too much information out there to the point that you have to find a way on how can you effectively filter the right influencers, the right brand advocates that you would like to work with. How can you design campaigns that can be relevant to people to the point that you can maximize the engagement that you can possibly get out of it? And how do you monitor responses and analyze them in a reasonable way without necessarily over-exaggerating it to a client, whether on a positive or a negative perspective? And then the moment you decide to become a service provider, how can you package your services so that you can be competitive enough to the point that you can get the kind of compensation that you deserve, but at the same time, your client will also get the return on investment that they deserve. No? So all of these, matrabaho siya in terms of, especially if you're learning it from a point of view of executing a live project. And that's when we realized that I guess it's our obligation to provide additional resources that our students can get access to and help them in their journey towards becoming a certified blog and social media entrepreneur. So all of these free resources that we've done is also for them. And then the summit, we hope that we can also use that as an opportunity to give them the exposure that they deserve to market their products and services online. So our topic for tonight is all about social conversation. So if you are ready with our topic for tonight, I guess we can proceed. So when we talk about social conversation, it's all about gathering and analyzing. As I indicated here, it's all about gathering and analyzing content that you've found, you've processed and reviewed, and shared through platforms, allowing users to discuss it further. I think, well, of course, it's an attachment to social content creation. Yesterday or last night, we talked about social content creation. But the challenge in social content creation is that it's just about creating the content. But the next part would be, it's all about extending it to the conversation. And that is what we're going to discuss for tonight. Now, there are many tools that you can do to spark conversation. In sparking conversation, it doesn't necessarily mean that the content that you're sharing necessarily comes from yourself. No? It can come from multiple resources, and you play a role of putting them together and more or less filter the kind of content that you have. So some of the tools or platforms that you can use can be the likes of paper.ly, magnify.net, and Flipboard. For this limited time that we have, the example that I'm going to show would be paper.ly. So let's now move on to our browser and check out paper.ly. So this is paper.ly, and basically, what the website does, may nakikipag-chat sa akin. Unfortunately, hindi ko na siya masasagot kasi nag-live webinar na tayo. So, Let me see if I can. Okay. Isara na natin. Baka akalain niya na sasagot ko siya. Okay. So sa paper.ly, ang nangyayari sa kanya, all you need to do is to set up an account. You can log into your Twitter or Facebook account to create a paper.ly account. So what I've done is I've made this account and I have no regrets because automatically it allows me to have a filter of sorts as to what my friends or the people that I follow on Twitter have been sharing and then putting them in one page, no? But rather than just absorbing what everybody is sharing, ang pinipick up niya yung mga nakikita niyang popular na content na it's either a lot of people are sharing it through various Twitter accounts or through various Twitter personalities. And while others would be more in the form of there's a content that got shared and then maybe there was a lot of conversation or the tweets that also, as a result, became popular. What I noticed is that if you follow a certain set of people, there is a big possibility that their paper.ly becomes similar to each other in terms of content. So I would suggest having some form of diversity so that you can more or less filter the kind of content that you can have, no? So if you can edit your paper.ly so that you can customize it, so that if in case you will have content that you don't like and you just want to stick to some form of content, that is something that you can do, no? So like in this case, every day nag-generate siya, nagpipick up siya ng content, and then you can also customize it, like you can put up an editorial box, no? And if you don't like a content, you can delete it, and you can also promote a content so that it will go sa headline, no? So yun ang nagustuhan ko sa paper.ly as a service. So yun ang suggestion ko sa inyo. If you want to have a curation tool that will allow you to gather all articles and put them together and publish it publicly, I think paper.ly is one of the best resources. Another resource that you can use is Flipboard. So this is Flipboard. Yung nga lang yung Flipboard, hindi talaga siya pang browser, no? You will have to use an iPad or an iPhone or your Android device in order to be able to enjoy Flipboard. And this will allow you to monitor content. You can subscribe to specific types of content or follow certain people on social networks. And then the kind of content that they share is the one that will be gathered together on your Flipboard, and then that will allow you to read through content that merits your interest. So yun naman para sa mga mobile phone users, and then parang subscribing ka to specific resources. However, between paper.ly and Flipboard, I kind of enjoy my paper.ly much better kasi mas social siya. So for example, this is my Twitter ID, and then what happens here in my Twitter ID is that if people would like to participate in the discussion, what happens is that they can either reply to what they saw via paper.ly, while the others, pag nakita nilang na-tag sila, so like in this case, yung iba, ang ginagawa nila, ni-retweet nila. Kaya, as a result, since medyo matagal-tagal na rin yung paper.ly ko, medyo marami-rami na rin siyang shares, no? As indicated here, this was already shared more than 2,000 times, no? So, since marami-rami na rin naka-share sa kanya, in fact, I saw even some people sharing it on Facebook, and some really read it and take time. Kaya sa akin din, madalas binabantayan ko siya para kung meron akong mga nakitang content na tingin ko hindi siya ganun ka-relevant para sa isang paper, tinatanggal ko siya. Like yung mga announcement ng mga contest, sharing ng mga cloud pages. Kasi sayang eh, I follow more than, how many ba do I follow? I think I follow more than 3,000 persons on Twitter. So there's so much content that I can pick up from the 3,000 that I follow. So I might as well take advantage of the kind of content that I can get. So pag halimbawa meron ding user na medyo nagdo-dominate, pwede mo siyang i-blacklist. Hindi naman siya mawawala as one of the as one of the persons that you follow on Twitter. Ang mangyayari lang, kung ano man yung mga sinishare niya, hindi ka na magpipick up sa kanya. So at least hindi niya madodominate yung publication mo, no? Meron din siyang, I think, mga widgets so that if you have content or kung gusto mo na gusto mo ma-share sa kanya o automatically ma-add, lalo na kung nag-update ka, meron din siyang ganung feature kung gusto mong mag-add ng content sa site. And then, recently, one of the things that they've done also is meron na silang subscription, so you can go pro. And if you go pro, you can also put advertisement among others. And then more or less, well, parang it gives you the opportunity to monetize your publication. That is something that I'm currently considering because lumalabas, pwede ako maglagay ng ads sa kanya. Kasi di ba napansin nyo, meron siyang mga ad widgets dito. So, kung tutusin, kung talagang seryoso ako sa kanya, well, more or less, I'm nearly getting there. So, maybe I think that is something that I will do in a month or two and really formalize my paper.ly and, you know, really guard it and put it more content. And subscribe to it. So if you like to curate, you like to aggregate the best content, and well, especially if you don't have time to read through the content that is being shared by your friends, I think paper.ly is a great resource. But remember, paper.ly will only work for you if you follow also good people. The quality of your publication will heavily depend on the kind of people that you follow. So if you follow good ones, then more or less there's a bigger promise or there's a bigger possibility that the kind of content you will be able to aggregate on your site will be better too. Okay. So by the way, if you want to participate in the okay. Mukhang, alright. Okay, somebody shared na hindi siya makapasok. So, I'm not so sure if EJ can enter here. EJ, I'm not sure if you're here. Hi, EJ, you can join here. Ang hirap lang dito sa Google Hangout since I said to share my screen. So as a result, talagang ano ngayon, no? Lahat ng gawin ko ngayon sa computer ko, nakikita ngayon sa screen. So this is very medyo awkward siya kasi sa GoToMeeting kasi pwede kang mag-pause and then pwede kang magpalikutin doon sa screen mo na walang makakakita. But in this case, everybody can see it and then a lot of people now cannot enter the room for one reason or another. Actually, kanina, hindi ako makapasok sa webinar room. So, I tried to find a way na lang. I don't know kung paano ko siya napawork, pero nakapasok din ako sa room. But now, I'm getting text messages from friends who avid, well, kahit paano, they'd make time to join the webinar sessions, not being able to enter the room. So, well, we'll do the best that we can for tonight, and I hope we can, you know, kahit paano, maximize natin tong feature na to. Sabi nga nila, there's always a first time, you know, for everything. So, again, if you have any questions at any point, I guess you can use the Twitter platform right now to express your questions, and my Twitter ID is DigitalFilipino, and you can also use the hashtag DimBootcamp. For the lucky ones who are able to enter the room, at least may mga ilan na nakapasok, maswerte kayo, yung iba hindi na makapasok, one said, can I send paper.ly content through email list? I think what paper.ly allows you to do, let me just go to my paper.ly and share it to you. Meron siyang mga functionalities like, saan ba yun? Yung ating paper settings. Okay. Doon sa paper settings, I think pag nag-upgrade kaya to Pro, one of the features na binibigay niya, pwede ka na mag ano sa email list. So, I guess maganda siya kung halimbawa gumagamit ka ng MailChimp, no? Among others. So, pwede siyang mag-email. Kaya lang kung gagamitin mo 'yon, kailangan naka-upgrade ka. You have to use the Pro edition. And I think the Pro edition is $9 per month if I'm not mistaken. So, pwede ka rin mag-send a notification through Twitter. and among others. And then you can configure the appearance, no? So marami kang pwedeng gawin. Meron din yata siyang stats feature, pero I think yung mga iba pa niyang pwedeng gawin, mas makikita mo na yung features niya kung naka Pro Edition ka. Alright? So, do we have any more questions about paper.ly or the likes of Flipboard? Kung wala na tayong question tungkol sa kanya, for those of you in the GoToMeeting room, can you press that raise your hand button so I will know if you have questions or not? Okay. Nako, may pumasok pa sa live chat. Okay, multitasking pala ako ngayong gabi. Hold on ah. Asan yun? What's that? Okay. Nag-live chat. Okay. Mina. I am in a webinar right now. We'll get back. Kindly leave your contact info and your question. Nag-customer support ako. Kindly leave your email info and with your question, and I'll get back to you. Get back. My response. Alright. Sige, balikan tayo sa discussion natin. Sorry. Question, do you have any more questions about paper.ly? At least for the 6 months who were successfully able to enter the room. For the ones on YouTube right now, if you have questions, unfortunately, I don't think I can view the YouTube site because if I view the YouTube site, then that means pakikita ko yung ginagawa ko. Baka mag-conflict ako dun sa audio. So if you have questions, you can send a message via Twitter. And I think may konting delay, no, from what I'm saying to what appears on YouTube. So I guess we'll just do what we can. So what I'm going to do right now is move on to our next topic. So I'm going to close paper.ly already, and I'm also going to close Flipboard. By the way, the inspiration for our topic tonight, for yesterday's topic and for tonight's topic, is the conversation prism created by Jestri and Brian Solis. And it basically talks about the social conversation that is happening all around us. And these conversations happening in various platforms. And the challenge now is that if you have interesting content or if you have something to share, you want to build your reach, relevance, resonance, as discussed as the pillars of influence. There are now many channels that you need to explore in order to carry that out. So it's now about finding the right channel. So some channels is more for content dissemination, while there are channels that are more apt for curation, meaning you shared links that you've read online and engage with people and have a discussion with that, or basically answering what people's concern is all about. So it's just a matter, so the challenge now is how can you use all of these platforms to decide which one you can work with the best, no? Okay, so let's go back to my presentations. So that is social curation. Another option that you may have is reviews and ratings. And there are many reviews and ratings websites around, like Amazon.com, where you can post your review on books and products that are found online. However, for the Philippine context, I guess the reviews are useful in a sense that it can read the reviews, and then you can decide whether you want to buy the product or service, not necessarily through Amazon, but maybe through offline. Opinions, I think this is more popular also for abroad. Locally, what I noticed is that some of the sites that are very popular would be the likes of TripAdvisor. And then, sa TripAdvisor, pwede kang mag-leave ng comment, feedback dun sa mga establishments na napuntahan mo. And in some cases, minsan meron pa mga establishments who would really make time to give you a reply or feedback dun sa mga sinabi mo. So I think very useful siya. In my case, where I've also used TripAdvisor, is that like right now, I've been having a lot of events sa mga provinces. And And usually, one of the entities that I invite in my events are hotels, no? Hotels, restaurants, resorts, tourist destinations, manage tourist destinations, among others. And searching them online, although if you Google the establishments in, let's say, hotels in Davao or hotels in Cebu or hotels in Cagayan de Oro, it will yield results in Google. But I also find it helpful to do the searches in review sites. Like, halimbawa, looking for hotels in Cebu will also give you a good listing. No? TripAdvisor will yield a good listing for you that you can use. And okay din naman siya, no? Valid siya, magandang reference siya. At minsan magkakaroon ka pa ng mas better understanding so that kung merong talagang a-attend sa event mo na nagkataon na tourism establishment siya, o kaya merong makikipag-set up na meeting sa'yo and you want to know them better or what services do they offer better, reading what people say about them in review sites can be of great help. Lalo na yung mga tips na iniiwan ng mga tao. Okay? I am supposed to log in. Teka, tingnan ko nga kung makakapag-sign in ako. I should be able to. So, right now, I'm signed in. And then, naglagay ako ng review before. And ano ba ang aking reviewer profile? Okay. So, pututusin. Ayan, meron na pala akong nagawang review. So, welcome back daw. Ang sabi niya sa akin. I'm not so sure kung saan ako makikita yung reviews na ginawa ko na. Pero I guess I can post more reviews. Okay, one of the places I really like is, let's say, Palawan. I know, Boracay. I was there recently. And tignan natin kung sino yung ilalabas niya. And then, maybe we can look for, okay, mukhang hindi ko siya makikita dyan. Mukhang I really have to type it. So, release, yun, Release Beach Club. So, nandyan siya. And then, ang gagawin ko, mag-write ako ng review. I've been using them as a venue for my seminars and events. And these people are very, very nice. They've been very accommodating. They've been very kind. And I think it's about time that I should give them a review. So my overall rating of this property, well, hindi ko lang nagawa pa mag-stay doon. Kasi parang palaging tuwing pumupunta ako sa Boracay, palagi na ako may nako-committed na stay. Hindi pa ako nakapag-stay sa kanila. Pero yung facilities na gamit ko na. So, I guess I can give them a great rating. So, title of review, nice place to hold a seminar. I was able to conduct my workshops here for... I was able to conduct my workshops here several times in the past 2 years. Three times in the past 2 years. The staff, internet connection is stable, and very friendly service. Very friendly. And flexible service. And then it is also nice to hold a workshop that allows your participants to immediately have a view of the beach. It helps in creativity. Okay, really done. So this is a highly recommended workshop venue. Okay? So, nakita niyo, so parang ganito siya, no? And then, what sort of trip was this? Well, definitely it's a business trip. And when did I travel? I was there last July only. and I like the service. I have no problem with that. I like the value. Sleep, well, I did not sleep there, so I cannot say that. Definitely, cleanliness is okay. Location is okay. So, do I have photos to share? Yes, I have a photo to share. So, mag-click lang ako ng add photo. Yung nga lang, kailangan kong mamili ng photo. So, I will go now to my photo album and look for a photo. Photo. So, kailangan natin maghanap ng photo. Buti na lang, kakatapos lang nung event na yun recently. So, dapat mas madali ako makakapaghanap ng photo niya. Yung nga lang, mukhang... Okay, mukhang ano, pictures, and then I'm gonna sort it. I need to sort it by date modified, and I was there noong July 11. So I guess we can choose one photo. I think this is a good photo. So gawin ko siyang Boracay release July 11. Para lang meron akong masubmit na photo. So I'm gonna type here. And while waiting for that, it seems we have a message. Okay. So EJ, I hope you're there, and I hope you can see my screen. This is really complicated. You know, kututusin kinakabahan ako ngayon doing this webinar, pero I guess I have no more choice kasi dahil nandito na tayo. It's hard to cancel now kasi masyado nang sunod-sunod yung mga events, and parang feeling ko if I don't do this now, masyado na siyang mamu-move back. Okay, so that's the photo, and I say I'm gonna upload it to support the review that I did. What happened here? Okay. So ina-upload na siya. And so papasok na siya dyan, and then yun. I think maganda yung if you want to become a digital marketing practitioner, and you know, you want to build your digital influence, I think it's important that you have accounts and review sites, and really, you know, become an advocate. Yung talagang kung may nakita ka magandang service, purihin mo. Kung meron kang hindi nakitang okay, mag-critique ka ng konti, magbigay ka ng feedback, no? Okay, hold on. This is center, beach area. Beach area ba tawag dito? Dining, no, it's a dining area. So, this is the digital marketing and e-commerce bootcamp for tourism industry. Hi, Janet Toral. Kailangan lagyan ko ng pangalan ko kasi akin yung picture. So, I am the owner. So, pasok na siya dyan, no? And then, held last July 11, 2013. Okay, tanggalin ko na yung held. Last July 11, 2013. So, ayan siya, no? So, I have to authenticate that my review is genuine, that I'm not being paid to do this review. So, I'm gonna submit this review. Actually, kaya ko, ang nagustuhan ko lang sa release, hindi siya yung mahigpit na sasabihin sa'yo, okay lang, marami ah. So, kung tutusin, very friendly siya. Okay lang sa yung madali silang kausap, like sasabihin mo, sorry, I only have I only have a small group. I hope you can still accommodate us. So sila, very accommodating sila. And I find that very rare in a lot of establishments, because a lot of establishments will require you to have at least 20, 30 people. But sila, kahit na, let's say, you only have 10 people or 12 people, okay naman sila, they're very nice. And to me, since a lot of the seminars that I do in the provinces are really advocacies, no? Kasi ito naman yung mga tipong konti pa lang umaattend kasi konti pa lang yung gustong matuto, o kaya konti lang yung nakaka-appreciate pa ng value niya. So, parang nagbe-build ka muna ng awareness sa market. So, you need to find places that will allow you to do that kind of task, but at the same time, without really breaking an arm and a leg, no? Para ma-afford mo lang siya. So, that's why I really like Willy's in Boracay. Alright. So, I hope medyo mas na-clarify ko na kung what you can do with TripAdvisor. So, kung may mga nakikita kang feedback ng mga ibang establishments, actually, you can also participate in the discussion whether you agree or disagree, no? So, marami ka naman pwede magawa sa kanya. Okay? So, that's TripAdvisor for you. Okay, so balik tayo dun sa ating presentation. Another tool that you can use to spark social conversation is crowd discussion forums. And there are a lot of popular crowd discussion forums out there. It seems the one that have prevailed in the fight for the social conversation using crowd forums will be the likes of Reddit. That is a very popular site. Yung nga lang, pa medyo sanay ka dun sa business structure, medyo nakakapanibago si Reddit. Kasi yung the way they put their content, talagang very personal. Halimbawa, my dad's pretty proud of the picture he took. Like yung nakita niya yung number 2 or number 3. So parang it's very, very personal with the way they share the content. And parang it's really more expressive na mga thoughts nila rather than just para nag-share lang siya ng article, nag-gay siya ng link. So, kung hindi ka ganun ka-personal mag-share ng content, medyo mahihirapan kang gamitin ng Reddit. So, for me, I must admit, it's a struggle for me to use Reddit kasi hindi ako sanay sa kanyang klase ng communication when sharing content. Yung parang tipong, how do you call it? Parang talagang totally, ano yung tawag niya doon? Speaking your mind out loud or writing, parang ganun siya, parang talking out loud, ganun ang pagpo-post ng content pagdating sa Reddit. Kasi pag hindi ka ganyan, huwag kang umasa na may mag-a-up araw ng content mo. Walang mag-a-up ng content mo. If you really want people to take notice of your content, you must be, mas personal, no? So, yun napansin ko, nag-click sa kanya. Yung Dig, actually, nung una, medyo nakakalito yung Dig kasi parang nagbago sila ng structure. If you visit dig.com, parang may mga content siya, parang mahirap hanapin yung submit a link. Hindi kagaya before, nandun siya sa pinakataas. Ngayon lumabas, nandun na siya sa pinakababa. So, halimbawa, if you found an interesting content online that you think will be worth sharing, then you can post it there. And then, it's up for the people to decide whether they think there's value in it and whether they would want to participate in the discussion or not. Yung nga lang, para pumasok ka sa front page, para maging top story ka, the community must really, well, more or less support the story that you've just shared, no? At mag-agree sila na, okay ang story na yan, relevant yan. So, syempre, pag nagbasa ka ng dig.com, karamihan ng mga users niyan are based abroad. Konti lang yung mga contributors na galing sa Philippines. Although, may mga nakikita ka rin naman. Pero yung mga contributors sa Philippines, halos hindi naman ganun magkakakilala. Wala talagang big na dig community na very organized. And as a result, parang bihira yung mga local content na nag-rank high sa mga content sites like this one. Unless, siguro you're really part of a crowd at nagtutulungan kayo para mag-promote, you know, to push each other's content and gain traction or attention using platforms like dig.com. Okay? So that is Dig. I'm trying to figure out if there's, other sites that we can, ang hirap eh, kasi medyo challenging siya sa akin ngayon kasi hindi kagaya before. Kung may question, tingnan mo lang yung GoToWebinar, magkakaroon ka lang ng feedback. Pero ngayon, parang it's hard kasi we're using a different platform altogether. So if you have any questions at any point, of course, you can use Twitter. And our hashtag is DimBootcamp. And that's where you can post your questions. Alam, may nag-share na ng screen. Okay. So to Czar and to EJ, thank you very much for joining us tonight. So if you have any questions, you can post it here. So medyo nakakapanibago talaga siya, pero I hope masanay din ako. Siguro baka talagang time na rin na mas gamitin siya, no? Hi, okay. So kamusta yung mga nasa webinar room? So it seems the people in the webinar room are still here, the lucky ones who were able to enter. So yung iba, nagpapadala na ng tanong through text. Okay, ang tanong, it seems, ano to? Alright. Okay, some people from Bohol are having a hard time catching up with the... Okay. Hindi raw makakonect sa internet nila. Sige. It seems there's a lot of glitches happening tonight for some reason. Okay. Sige. So, mukhang wala namang questions. So, I guess we can proceed with our discussion. Hindi na ako siguro magde-demo ng dig. Pero parang gusto kong mag-demo. I'm just thinking kung anong story ang isi-share ko. So, maybe what we can do is to look for an interesting story. Ano ba ang pwede natin i-share? Ah, okay. Sige, pwede. There's an upcoming event called the NRCE. So, well, it's an event. So, pero pwede na rin, just for the sake of example. So NRCEPH.com. Tingnan natin kung tatanggapin niya. Ah, National Retail Conference and Exposition. Ah, bawal yung ano? Bawal ang mother site. Okay. Okay. I'm thinking. Kung tatanggapin niya. Although parang tingin ko hindi dahil mas naka-focus siya ngayon sa mga content, no? So maybe we'll just go to the site and pull in an article that we can use for this discussion. And then what I'll do is I'll pick this article on Get Your Startup Running. And tignan natin kung tatanggapin niya para makapag-demo tayo. Okay, yun lang. Tinanggap na niya. And then, sasabihin niya, do you want to submit another? So, unlike before, kapag nagsasubmit ka sa DIG, pwede ka pang mag-editing, pero ngayon, hindi na, no? So, wala na siyang ganun feature. Hindi ka na ganun makapag-editing. So, I think yun yung challenge niya. So, kaya as a result, parang hindi na siya kagaya before with the different flexibility that you can do. Although, pwede mo rin sabihin na dahil sa mas filtered, mas maganda rin yung content na pumapasok sa homepage. Unlike before, na parang medyo mukha siyang syndicated. Or kaya siyang i-rig or i-syndicate. At least ngayon, talagang mas may filtering na siya. Okay? So, that is DIG. And that is Reddit. Okay. Saan na ba tayo? Alright. So another tool that you can use is to engage in Q&A forums. And there are I have three favorite Q&A forums, one of which is Yahoo Answers. So Yahoo Answers, well, actually, yung Yahoo Answers ko, naka-install siya sa aking Android phone. So, usually, kapag nanatraffic ako, dalawa lang ang nangyayari dyan. Either titingnan ko yung Facebook ko para mag-like lang ng content kasi that's the only time na nakakapagbasa ako ng newsfeed and like people's content and comment. Kaya pa nakaganon ako, ibig sabihin nun, nasa on the road ako. Pag talagang sobrang waiting time, usually I hang out in Yahoo Answers and answer it also from the mobile phone. So this is where you can post questions and answer questions. And mukhang meron tayong mail. Is that? Oh, Yahoo Mail siya. So you can browse open questions and decide if you want to participate in the discussion. Ang ginagawa ng mga bloggers, madalas tumitingin sila dyan, and then, titingnan nila kung kaya nilang sagutin yung tanong. And then, kung kaya nilang sagutin yung tanong, usually what they will do is they will blog about it, and then they will go back to the page and answer the question. And then, put a link back to their blog site para ma-promote nila yung sagot nila. So, ang gagawin ko, mag-search ako tungkol sa, tignan ko lang kung may nagtanong, tungkol sa mind mapping. Mind mapping, what's the difference between free? Kaya lang, ang tagal na siya nasagot. Date submitted, siguro last 30 days, apply. Okay. Okay. Medyo weird yung tanong. Hindi tungkol sa mind mapping, meron tungkol sa pag-ibig at kung ano-ano. Tingnan natin kung may tanong tungkol sa e-commerce. And okay. What can I make? So, pwede kang tumingin kung saan ka topic may interest. And then see which one that you would like to answer. So, halimbawa, meron dito nagtanong, which web host service is best for a small business? Okay, so babasahin natin siya. I don't need anything too complex, just a solid range of e-commerce features and such. Would love to hear experience from other small business owners on reliability and support, among other things. Okay, so may sagot na dito, HostGate, mukhang siya yung chosen na best answer. Pero ako, meron akong ibang sagot. Sasagutin ko ba siya? Pwede ko bang sumagot? Other answers? Okay. Mukhang ano na siya eh. It's a resolved question. So, hindi na siya open question. So, ang kailangan natin makita yung mga last 3 days na question. So, can... Okay. I was wondering about... Ah, may nagtatanong tungkol sa ano. Newest... Okay. Mukhang walang gano'ng nagtatanong tungkol sa kanya. So, lagyan natin, palawakin natin yung question. Gawin natin social media. And there we go for... What are the methods to use social media as a promotional tool for blogs? Okay. So, magsasagot lang ako ng isa kasi sayang, nandito na rin lang naman tayo. We might as well answer some question para ma-demonstrate natin yung feature, anong functionality ni Yahoo Answers. Tama-tama, meron akong ginawang blog post na more or less, sagot ko siya dun sa tanong. No? So, pupuntahan ko yung blog post ko, and then ang gagawin ko sa kanya, ililink ko siya, no? So, social media marketing for newbies. I wrote this article some time ago. And then, gagawin ko, sasagutin ko yung tanong niya, tapos mag-link back ako dito sa blog post na to para as additional reference dun sa person nagtatanong. So, what are the best methods to use social media as a promotional tool for blogs? Okay. Hi. You can use social media to promote your, to do the following for your blog. For your blog. So, sabihin natin, share your blog post. Oh, meron na lang ako misspelling. Share your blog post to social media to attract readers and other resharers. And then, meet like-minded bloggers and readers who share the same passion as you do. In the process, build a following and depending on your approach, a community. Okay. So, of course, marami pa siyang pwedeng gawin, no? Pero for now, yan lang muna ilagay ko. And then, lalagay ko yung aking source. So, that's one way of doing it. Ideally, mas maganda if you can give 2, 3, 4, or more resources para kahit paano, yung reader, mas marami siyang pwedeng basahin para mas para na magagamit niya as reference. Pero kung halimbawa limited ka, kahit paano, pag nagbigay ka ng resource, lalo na if you have written something, maganda exposure na rin siya para sa site mo. Okay? So, by answering this, I will get 2 points and I can answer 40 questions today. So, the more I answer, the more akong magle-level up pa, no? Ang yung aking rank level sa Yahoo Answers. So, I'm gonna submit. Oh no, patag server error. Okay, tingnan natin. Testing natin ulit. Sana wag na. Yay! Di na nag server error. Okay. Sige. So ayan, sinagutan natin siya. My gosh. Live na live tong demo na to. Kinakabahan ako. All right. Another forum that you can use is Quora. And what I will do is I'm going to sign up with Twitter. Log on to my Quora. Okay, authorize. I hope this is the one that is connected. So, maglo-load ang aking profile. Yes, it's the right one. Okay. The website, what blogging platform is best to embed into an existing website? Ah, okay. Okay. So, maraming mga nagpo-post dito ng question. But, you know, one thing, I don't know about you, but for me, I find it challenging to engage in Quora. Kasi parang very, kung yung Yahoo Answers, medyo jetprox yung mga tao doon. Dito, parang feeling ko talaga elite yung audience. Pati yung mga nagpo-post ng mga answers, very eloquent sila in expressing themselves. You hardly see people here posting in Taglish. It's all in straight English, maybe because of the community, you know, the people in the community. So therefore, it requires a certain level of formality when engaging in a conversation. So it's a challenge to have a more casual conversation in this community. But of course, if you are the kind of person na who likes to engage and you are comfortable with what you know and you think that you can be in a position to engage in an audience like this one, I think okay naman siyang i-explore and build your identity in this community. All right? Tingnan natin kung saan tayo pwedeng pumasok. You know, nakapag-participate lang ako dito nung mahilig ako sa game. There was one social media game that I really like, and that was what was that social game? Empire Avenue. So there was a time I really got addicted to Empire Avenue, and then I was looking for questions about Empire Avenue, and then talaga answer ko talaga siya kasi alam ko siya eh. Pero kung halimbawa ang mga answer to ko sa blogging and everything, mukhang mahirap yata makipagpaligsahan dyan. So, if you want to call it a contest. So, let's now read some of the questions here. So, since I like paper.ly and I've been using it a lot, I'm gonna follow it as a topic. I can post a question if I want to. And then I can also read questions posted by people. What do people think of paper.ly. Okay, so I'm gonna read it. Sige nga. Mukhang kaya ko yung sagutin. Okay. Okay. So people are answering, what do they think? Okay. So ako, maglalagay ako ng opinion ko. I'm gonna say I love Paper Dudley. I love Paper Dudley. I don't get much time to read tweets from the people I follow. I love Paper.ly. I don't get much time to read tweets from the people I follow. Through Paper.ly, through this service, I am able to catch up and consolidate them in a publication style and share it daily to friends via Twitter. Yes, it is true that, yes, it is true. Sometimes not so good content gets in your publication, but I don't think it is the fault of the service. It should prompt you to check on the people you follow. You can either unfollow them on Twitter, or blacklist them on paper.ly so it won't on paper.ly so it won't get inside your feed. They give a lot of customization features also. I get feedback from friends how my daily helps them a lot in catching up with the latest from various users' point of view on news that matter to them. Okay? So makikita nyo, kapag gumamit kayo ng social conversational tools, I think yung through this demonstration, I hope what is clear is that importante na mahilig ka talagang makipag-converse. And yung mag-share ng opinion mo, mag-share ng perspective mo, of course, it's up to you whether what kind of tone you're gonna take. Are you going to engage in debate, or are you just going to express your perspective? It depends on what your passion is all about, no? Kung saan ka mas mag-focus. So, ikaw na mag-decide kung ano yung mas mag-work for you, no? So, what I'll do is gonna add the answer, and then I can share it. So, that means it will appear on my Twitter. I think yun ang mangyayari. So, let's see kung lalabas nga siya sa Twitter. Yay! Ayun, lumabas na siya. My answer to what do people think of paper.ly. So, it's there. So, tingnan natin ulit yung ating bootcamp. Okay. So, do you have questions on how to use the likes of Quora and Yahoo Answers for Q&A? So, okay siya kung talagang, I think saan ba siya talagang okay? For me, yung at least to warm you up. Like kalimbawa, lalo na kung gusto mo mag-vlog pero wala kang mag-vlog, wala kang masulat, or hindi mo alam kung ano susulatin mo. I think going to Q&A sites and finding out what people have been asking will be a good prompt for you to look at topics that you can write about. Like for example, yung mga taong yun na nagko-complain sila, it seems they don't like paper.ly. They have a lot of complaints about paper.ly. And ako naman, on my end, I really, really love the service. So, ibig sabihin, that gives me now an idea, maybe I should write about paper.ly and really express my love. You know, show support. Talagang talk about it and give suggestions to people on how can they maximize the use of the site and make it work for them in terms of building their influence, in building relationships. in doing research on what people think about the various services online. All right? So, kung wala tayong tanong about paper.ly or Quora, I'm gonna close this now. In LinkedIn, actually, you can join groups and participate in discussions. One of the groups that I've joined, saan ba yun? Ito, si Ted. Maraming mga interesting groups dito sa LinkedIn, no? So it's just a matter of deciding which group do you want to participate in and have a discussion with. So one of the interesting groups that I saw lately is yung, although it's an unofficial group yan, mga TED and people sharing their thinking, no, and giving their thoughts. Although it's not really an official group, I like the fact that the people are really taking a lot of time in fostering serious discussion. So meaning, if I really want to engage, there's always a LinkedIn group that I can join and have a good discussion with. So it's more or less like Quora, although the challenge with Quora is that you don't really have much of an idea about the person. But here, if I'm discussing with someone, and if I want to know more about the person, then I can always view the profile of the person and, you know, decide whether I want to know that person more or not. So, kaya kailangan sa LinkedIn, kung mag-join ka sa isang discussion group, makikipag-usap ka, you always have to put your best foot forward because at the end of the day, it reflects back to your profile. So, if you are into SEO, you can join SEO groups, marketing groups, advertising groups. If you are offering virtual assistant services, depending on your target market, you can join discussions where they are and more or less participate so that when people check you out, they will see what you do. Yung nga lang, if you're the kind of person who is not really good in expressing yourself in writing, it might be a challenge because yung mga Q&A sites, forum sites, really requires you to really go out of your way and engage in conversation. You know? So yun yung medyo challenge sa kanya. Okay? So, close natin yan. Another tool that you can use would be the commenting system. There are commenting facilities that you can use, no, in building conversation with people, and one of which is Discourse. So Discourse, this is something that bloggers can use to put on their site so that when people comment, pwedeng namo-monitor niyo yung replies, tapos pwedeng isa-centralize mo lahat yung mga comments mo. So halimbawa, if there are a lot of blogs that have been using that platform, then it allows you to use a unique ID tied into your identity, and then all of your comments on various sites gets aggregated in one service. So there was a time I was using several blogs and posting it here. Maganda siya sa, kasi maganda rin siya before for SEO kasi pwede mo palitan yung pangalan mo, palitan mo yung description mo, palitan mo yung website mo. And once you've committed the changes, it will reflect to all of the blogs where you've left comments in, no? Meaning, if anyone would visit them and would click on your name, then they will be able to see your identity online. Yun nga lang, parang pwede rin siya ma-abuse in that regard. So, that's also the reason why I'm gradually removing it from my blogs. And now with Google+, I'm now moving towards using Google+ more as a default commenting service. Pero ganito yung itsura niya. So, like, halimbawa, nag-leave ako ng comment sa isang blog where one of my students talk about who between Angel Locsin and Marianne Rivera is Philippines' Facebook sweetheart. Hindi niya sinagot yung tanong niya. So, nag-post ako ng tanong. So, who won na? Tanong ko sa kanya. And then, sumagot siya. So, yung sagot niya, nakikita ko rito. So, if I visit several blogs who have installed Discourse as a commenting system, kung merong mga bagong feedback sa akin, makikita ko rin siya. No? At sabi rin dito, people you know from Discourse are already people you know from Facebook are already using Discourse. You can now follow them and discover new communities. So, kung tutusin, marami na siyang nialagay pang mga ibang features. Okay? I think we we have passed the 8 o'clock mark, so let me just go through the remaining ones. You can also do niche or enterprise networks, so which is more for, let's say you want to do it more for companies, no? So built for business siya, so you can use tools like SocialCast. I think there's another one called, si SocialCast yung medyo popular, no? Although there are other tools that you can use. Kung medyo iba-iba yung, kung gusto mo nung mas may multiply na feel, like maybe not really meant for business but more for establishing your own community or your own social network, you can use platforms like Ning. So like in my case, I have this Ning site that I had for quite some time. I'm still figuring out actually what I'm going to do with this. I'm paying more than $200 a year to maintain this site. I've used this platform in the past para i-store yung mga videos ko. Kasi there was a time that Google was only allowing 10 minutes worth of video time and 100 meg file size. I think 100 meg. But Ning then was already allowing more than 100 meg and beyond 10 minutes. So it became my video server for quite some time. Although now, with the upgraded features, hindi na niya ginagawa yon. Although what I like about Ning is that you can have a blog, you can post videos, you can, oh, nandiyan pala yung aking stream, no? So you can have a blog, you can post videos, you can have pictures. Your members will also have their own profiles. So para siyang multiply. It really feels like multiply. No? Parang every person will be able to configure their profile and put everything they want about themselves. Post their photos, videos, participate in forums, put events, put groups, among others. So nagamit ko siya for some period nung ginawa ko siyang platform for the nomination in our award. So I guess kung kailangan mo ng niche networking sites that's only limited to a few people, like for your organization, among others, okay na rin siya. Yung nga lang talagang ano eh, iba talaga Facebook eh. When Facebook became available and a lot of people started using Facebook groups, talagang naapektuhan yung mga ibang sites. Like in my case, in communicating with my students, even though there's Edu20 that I use for the Certified Blog and Social Media Entrepreneur Program, iba pa rin talaga yung nasa Facebook na kayo eh. Kasi kahit paano nandun na lahat, mas at home, yung parang nasa comfort zone siya pag ginagamit. But still, I'm sure there's still value for these type of sites. It's just a matter of you as the community owner on how you're going to maximize it for your members. Okay? So, I guess that's it. That's our topic for our webinar for tonight. So, this is the last webinar in the Digital Influencer Bootcamp series that we're doing for free. So, if you want to learn more about digital marketing for free, all you have to do is just visit digitalfilipino.com/influencer to watch all of our past webinars that we've posted online. So, maraming salamat po sa pag-join nyo tonight. At what I'm going to do is I'm going to pause already the broadcast. And thank you for joining. So to leave this webinar, just click on File, Exit, Leave Webinar. So good night, everyone. At dun sa mga hindi nakalogin, I'm very sorry because of the technical difficulty that we had tonight. I'm thinking now whether I'm going to organize another session, but it seems bukang okay naman yung discussion natin for tonight. We'll just upload the video. Share it on the page and allow you guys to watch it. Doon sa mga nag-text, I'm sorry, di natin siya mako-control because we're using a third-party service. We don't really know what's happening. But I'm very, but I'm lucky na after a few attempts, na finally I got inside GoToMeeting and saw the 6 people who are inside the room right now. For those who weren't able to join, check out the e-learning platform and you will be able to find all the videos there. So thank you again. So let's end the broadcast.